The regional trade body representing the shopping centre industry in the Middle East and North Africa, the Middle East Council of Shopping Centres, is this year celebrating its 20th year in the region. And although the industry's phenomenal success here does call for celebration, there is still a lot of hard work ahead, as we caught up with David Macadam, the CEO of MECSC. Each household in Dubai spends an average of 53,000 dirhams per year. This, coupled with a strong rebound in the tourism and hospitality sectors, Dubai's retail segment will be worth an astounding 150 billion dirhams by the end of 2014. Earlier this year, A.T. Kearney's latest global index revealed that the UAE is now ranked as the world's fourth most attractive retail destination, rivaling far more established global shopping hotspots like London, Milan, New York, and Sydney. And although the UAE's current shopping scene is quite impressive, to say the least, its beginnings were far more modest. Now, the Middle East Council of Shopping Centres is celebrating 20 years of presence in the region, and to mark its 20th anniversary, a special edition book is being launched, which captures images from as far back as the 1800s to date. In your opinion, what have been some of the major milestones in the region's retail sector when you do look back on its development?
I think that the basis for all of retail in the region has always been the souk. So the souk was some place that was near the coast or near some trade route, because it was turning the warehouse area. That's what it was originally started for. And then it also became a retail area for so many of the people that would come and be able to buy what they had to buy. So starting with the souks, that was the first, and then it sort of graduated through. I think the climate here had a big impact on the evolution of retail, and we showcase that in the book. And once you have an interior mall established and the air-conditioned environment, it became very attractive for everyone to hang out, and it became very much a social place to hang out. And people tended to dress and look appropriate and be sort of very social in their whole times that they spent at the mall. So it really was in the early 80s, late 70s, early 80s in this region, Dubai in particular, that it became very, very prominent. People would go and shop and hang out at the shopping centers. And then the evolution of the shopping center really started to take place, because there was a requirement to have a little higher level of environment. And people here had begun to travel. So they would go around the world and they would see that there are great retail environments everywhere else in the world, and why wouldn't they have that? So then you look and see that there's a higher level of execution. When I first came here in 2004, I felt that the level of execution of the shopping centers on a global basis was around here, and other places like Los Angeles, New York, or Sydney were probably here. And now what I see is the level of execution of the shopping centers and the retail environments locally, Dubai Mall, Mall of the Emirates, is here, and the rest of the world is here. So what I love to see in this book and what we can showcase in it is that the growth and the evolution of retail has been just dramatic, particularly in this region.
So how does the Middle East Council of Shopping Centres facilitate in the development and promotion of the region's retail industry?
We are an industry professional group, so we're part of the International Council of Shopping Centres. The International Council of Shopping Centers has 70,000 members globally. What we do is we facilitate business by putting people together in the relationships from around the world. So if you wanted to find out what a certain shopping center had done, say in Sydney or Los Angeles, and whether it could be translated into something that could be done and successfully done in Dubai, then I would enable the communication to take place, or I would put these people together and help them build the relationship so that they could share that information.
Today, shopping centers across the region are among some of the most vibrant and successful throughout the world. Even during the GFC, businesses proved to be resilient by adapting to the changing financial climate and maintaining their significance through creativity. There is definitely a change in the air, and at this year's Recon Middle East and North Africa, industry insiders will be exploring its new opportunities.
We spend a whole year working towards this day, so I'm thrilled because our team has worked very hard. What we try and do is we bring together the best and the brightest minds from around the world to showcase retail from other parts of the world. And it could be in the GCC, could be from London, could be from anywhere really, and New York. And in fact, we have speakers from New York and from Toronto, all over the world. And they come and they showcase what's really leading edge or trending in the retail business today. So how important is it? It's really important for people who are in the industry, particularly locally, if they want to find out what's trending, what can they do in their shopping center that's going to make a difference? How can they attract more traffic? How can they increase the dwell time? What does the future look like? How does, online shopping, how does that impact things? So it's going to be very important for people who are in the industry, the retail professionals, to get together. That's one reason. The other reason is that it's a time, a social time, when relationships are renewed or built upon or new people are met. And that's the other thing that we really like to do in our organization, is bring people together to learn and chat and meet and basically share their relationships.
And in general, what are some of the current and future market trends that you are seeing, and how can they be capitalized on?
Well, one of the things that I think is very important that, and this is a North American phenomenon, but things start there. There's been a lot of hype, particularly in the press and media, about how online shopping has dramatically increased and how has that impacted the sticks and bricks, the usual traditional shopping center. And what's really interesting to get right to the bottom of it is that the shopping center industry now in North America and around the world is on the up and up. So things are really moving ahead dramatically for them. Sales are up. They've increased 5% roughly in the United States year on year, which is a huge increase. So you're talking about billions of dollars every month. If you look at the shopping centers and you see all of the increase, it will only be a 5% increase. But that's on a bigger number. So you talk about in a month of September in the US, $144 billion, for instance. If you look at what's gone on the online, they say it's increased 17%, but the total number is only $38 billion. So it's a fraction. It's 20% of what has happened in the shopping center environment. But the media and the news pick it up that it's a huge impact, that it's going to close the shopping centers, it's going to have dramatic impact. What we can say is this, is that the B and C quality shopping centers, so those are the shopping centers that may not have been built at the right time, or they haven't been updated, or there haven't been their access, or there's other challenges with them. They're going to continue to have challenges. But the A quality, A minus, B plus shopping centers are literally, they're ramping up their sales. The retailers, there's a lineup at the door of many shopping centers now of retailers who want to open businesses. So I think if I could say there's one thing that's really happened, is that there's been a big increase in the amount of success and the amount of successful shopping centers and the amount of retail that's increased in total turnover. Well, I think that Expo 2020 is going to really impact the region overall, because there will be people coming from all over the world to see Expo 2020. And when they come here, they will come to Dubai, clearly, because in Abu Dhabi, because this is where the Expo is going to be held. But when they travel the 12 or 24 hours, whatever it is the flight is, to get here, they're going to want to see other places. For example, many will probably go to Jordan, see Petra, go to Cairo, see other places that are they've heard about, read about. And I think that that'll be a huge boom in the tourism in that time. What will it mean for Dubai, though? I think it'll mean a huge growth in the acknowledgement of Dubai and how Dubai has really grown from its roots to some place that's a cosmopolitan city that offers so many people so many different things that they don't find in other corners of the world. And one of the things that I came from Vancouver in Canada in 1986 with Expo 86 at the time, and one of the big monikers for it was invite the world to Expo 86. And in fact, in 1986 in Vancouver, 28 million people came, which was a lot of people in 1986. And several months after the Expo had finished, the newspapers reported that invite the world and they'll come, and they stayed. And I think that's what will happen in Dubai as well. So with all this new construction that's going on to host Expo 80, the Expo 2020, I think there's going to be a lot of great projects that are going to be occupied long term by the people who come here to enjoy Expo.
Now, the government of Dubai has announced that it will develop the Mall of the World. In your opinion, Do we need another mall?
Yes, I think so. I think the timing is perfect, actually. And the reason I say this is because if you look at Dubai Mall right now, you've got around 75 million people a year. And that's about 225,000, 250,000 people a day in the shopping environment. It, in the words of the shopping center industry, it's almost overtrading, meaning that it's not that comfortable to be in a mall that has that many people at one day. Also, same with Mall of the Emirates and some of the other malls that we have in Dubai. And that's with a base of around 10 million visitors. 10 million visitors come into in Dubai in 2013, and they expect maybe 10, 11, maybe in 2014. In 2020, we'll have 20 million at a minimum. And if Vancouver in Canada, which had no connectivity in terms of the airport, had 28 million, I think that there'll be a lot more than 20 million come to Dubai. And in which case, if these shopping centers are overtrading today with 10 million, we need another shopping center of equal size or larger, or shopping environments of equal size or larger to accommodate the people who will come. And then after that, it's a lifestyle. And I think that the level of execution of the shopping centers like Mall of the World and other shopping centers that will happen in Dubai will create a level of interest at all levels. So the 3-star, 4-star, 5-star, and the higher level. So we'll have value retail for those who can afford value. We'll have mid-tier product for mid-tier people. We'll have luxury for luxury people. And we'll have the aspirational all in between. And I think that's what makes a really successful retail environment. And I see Mall of the World checking all those boxes.
Dubai has been described as the epicenter of the region's retail industry. However, retailers both here and around the world have had to come to terms with a tougher trading environment, both as a result of the increasing cost of prime retail space, as well as the rise of online mega retailers, breaking down the traditional geographic borders of retail businesses. So how has the UAE been able to adjust to these challenges?
Well, I think the UAE is one of those places in the world that you're always surprised because it attracts the right people at the right time to get the right job done. My sense of it is that the online sales here won't impact things the way they have perhaps in other parts of the world. And as I was saying earlier, I think that the retail environments are going to become much more popular in the future. And there'll be many more things that we haven't even thought of today that'll take place in the malls that'll be important for all of us to live with.
Well, that brings us to the end of our program. If you would like to know more about any of the stories you have seen tonight, you can contact us at UAEweekly@city7tv.com or by calling us on 04-367-2230. For myself and the entire team, have a great week ahead.